Anyone that is making you feel bad about yourself, they gotta go. Like, it doesn't look attractive, does it? I'm gonna own this, and this is gonna be my favorite thing about myself. Hello, my name is Emma Miller, if you're new to the channel, and if you're returning, then welcome back. So, today, I'm gonna talk you through some of my instant hacks, my go-to things that I do to feel and look more attractive. And the things I'm gonna tell you about today, I kinda wish I knew, or at least put effort into doing a lot sooner. Some people think I've had a glow up over the last year. I lost some weight, changed the color of my hair, grew my hair, and just generally really decided to focus more on myself and look after myself. So a lot of the things I'm gonna talk about today are things that I myself practice, I've tried and tested, and they work. Maybe you've got a spring or summer vacation planned. Maybe, you know what, girl, you just wanna look and feel your best every day. So this video is for you. I think inner beauty is as important as outer beauty, so we're gonna touch on both of those things today. I'm also gonna share some insecurities I've had and how I got over them to feel more confident. And obviously when you feel more confident, you think positively, you attract positivity into your life. So, if you're not yet following me on Instagram, come follow me here. I've got a whole other world going on here. If you like this kind of video, you want to see more videos like this, then please do give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel and you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button below, come join, and yeah, let's begin. So number one hack is to make your hair look glossy, full, and healthy. First of all, I think regular treatments are important. I go to Neville's Hair Salon, they do an amazing job, but if you can't get to a salon, there are some amazing hair treatments you can do at home, DIY. For example, I love putting coconut oil on my hair. I like to put it on overnight. I sleep in it, I go to the gym in it, put my hair in a quick bun, put a cap over and head to the gym, and no one knows. And it's so hydrating on the hair, and when I obviously rinse it off, it makes such a difference. It makes my hair really glossy. When I think of having a glow up, I immediately reach for my hair curlers. When I have glossy, wavy hair, I just feel my best. I like straight hair as well. I like to mix it up. But if I go with straight hair, it looks extra thin. And obviously with the wave, it gives more volume and a little bit of bounce. So simple to do. I use my Babyliss little curler, super affordable on Amazon. I'll put the link in the description box below. And it takes me less than 15 minutes to do my whole head of hair. And instantly, you know, you look like you've gone to the hair salon and had a blow dry. Teeth whitening. Now, I wish I'd done this sooner. You just look healthier, you look fresher, you have nice white teeth. I went to my dentist, Dr. Beta, who was fantastic. I have little trays that I put the liquid into and just wear that overnight. It makes a big difference. And then when you have like nice white pearly teeth, you just really want to show it off. So naturally you're smiling. Smiling is an easy way to look and feel more attractive. And a study showed by Orbit found out that 66% of men, 73% of women thought a smile makes you more attractive than wearing makeup. So guys, save yourself all the effort putting the makeup on. Just smile. Skin. So for my skin, I love using a sheet mask on my face. Anything that brings hydration is so needed because my skin gets quite dry. If you don't have a sheet mask, one of the best masks you can do is like a homemade mask with avocado, a little bit of honey, some oats, and just put it directly onto your skin. I'll link all the ingredients that you need for my little DIY face mask below. And you get all that nourishment straight from the source into your skin. A scent. But wearing a great scent is so uplifting. It can take you to a time and a place, a location. It can be sexy, it can be romantic, it can be light and fresh and vibrant. Many different moods that can be brought about by wearing a gorgeous scent. My favorite is the one by Killian that I wear all the time. I also use the perfume sometimes on a brush and then I brush it through my hair, which just gives that gorgeous scent that lasts all night. I feel like it's really important to invest in good scents, whether it's for your body wash, your shampoo, choose something that you think is attractive. So when you put it on, you smell good, you feel good, and you look good. Onto styling and fashion. Choose an outfit or a style or a look that emphasizes your strong points. So whether you've got really long legs, whether you've got a chest that you want to show off, or a booty, whatever your strong point is, show that off. Maximize that and choose form-fitting outfits that really flatter your shape. If it's, for example, your chest area that you like, maybe you want to wear something low-cut. Just play on your strong points. Which I think makes a big difference to feeling and looking more attractive is posture. Because it's so easy to slouch, but nothing looks worse than someone who has bad posture. They look shy, they look a bit defeated, they look a little bit sad, lonely, depressed. But when you have good posture, you look confident, you look strong, empowered, ready to take on a challenge. Your body looks better. So always think about good posture. Shoulders back and down. Tummy in. Just try and work those core muscles. Exercise and diet will not only make you look good, you will feel better for it. When I go to the gym and I work up a sweat, I feel my best. I've got my hair up, no makeup, and I'm just sweating it out, doing a HIIT class. I just feel so freaking good and confident because I know I'm working my muscles and they're getting stronger and I'm better than I was yesterday because I went to the gym. If you can't get to the gym, there are some incredible HIIT workouts available on YouTube. I'll link my favorites in the description box below for you. Super easy to do. What you need is a space outdoors in the garden or in your home, a mat, and you're ready to go. So as part of my glow up and feeling more attractive was actually owning my insecurities, because there were parts of my body that I didn't like. And when I was younger, I always wanted to shrink my thighs, for example. But when I started actually thinking to myself, you know what? I'm gonna own this, and this is gonna be my favorite thing about myself, and all the great things about having bigger thighs. Thick thighs save lives. But that's something I just gravitate to now, and I think it's sexy. I think it makes me more womanly. Owning your insecurities can only empower you, make you feel stronger and more confident. Like, I get so many DMs about how do you get your confidence, where do you get confidence, how can I, you know, be more loving to myself. And I think what's really important is if you are struggling, is to tell yourself and look yourself in the mirror and pick out the things that you love about your body.
That's me. That's me. Oh my God, you see this?
Yes.
I'm beautiful!
About those, because we could all look in a mirror and think, oh, I hate that, I want to change that, oh, this isn't good enough. But if you go to the mirror and you think positively and think, oh yeah, I really like my hair today, or I really like my arms today, or I really like my butt, anything, whatever it is, like pick out the points that you love. If you start thinking positively, you're going to attract positivity to you. People gravitate towards positive people. So be that positive person, and be that positive person for others. You know, there's many people out there who are struggling with the same insecurities that you are. So if you can be a friend to them and help them, it makes you so much more attractive as a person. So another important hack to looking and feeling more attractive is to cut out toxic relationships. Whether it's a friend, a family member, or a boyfriend or a lover, anyone that is making you feel bad about yourself, they gotta go. Mm-mm. You haven't got time for that. Surround yourself with loving, supportive, encouraging people, people that wanna lift you up and have the best interests for you. So I think if you wanna look and feel more attractive, put down the phone. And yes, I need to practice what I preach. Definitely, hands up with that. I have a slight addiction to my phone, which I am working on. I'm working on, okay. When I feel myself in company looking at my phone, I like put my phone away, I close up my bag, and I'm like, you are not gonna look at that for the rest of the evening, because there's nothing worse than seeing someone look at their phone. The shoulders are kind of hunched inwards. You're looking down, so you've probably got like a double chin going on, chin from the side. I mean, like, it doesn't look attractive, does it? And more to the point is, like, no one's gonna approach you if you're on the phone. Like, if I don't wanna be approached, okay, and if I want to look busy, then I'll bring out the phone, you know? If it's awkward and I don't know what to say, I'll bring out my phone, right? But if you wanna look more attractive and be more approachable, you put the phone down and you look present in the moment, you look engaged and approachable. So, guys, put down the phone. It'll make a big difference, trust me on that one. So that's it for today's video. Those are all my hacks, tips, tricks on how to look and feel more attractive. I really hope they've helped some of you. They definitely reminded me of a few things that I need to think about and practice. Remember, guys, beauty is an attitude. To look and feel attractive, you need to love yourself first and foremost. Because if you don't love yourself, how the hell are you meant to love someone else? Let me know which are your favorite hacks. I love hearing from you. And if you like this video, found it useful, please do give it a big thumbs up. If you're new to the channel and you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button below. Come join, fresh videos every week. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys.